I'm Sean Doyle, and I'm British Airways' newly appointed Chief Executive. I'm delighted to join you to deliver today's keynote speech, and I wanted to use this session to introduce myself and to tell you that I do not underestimate the challenges ahead. Indeed, the stakes could not be higher for our industry, and I believe we will only overcome many of the challenges we face by working together. For those of you who don't know me, I spent more than 20 years of working at British Airways in a number of senior roles and became Chief Executive of Aer Lingus in January 2019. I've been back at BA for a week now, and my absolute priority is to ensure our resurgence from the worst crisis in the industry's history. British Airways has a crucial role in connecting Britain with the world and the world with Britain, and we are doing everything in our power to emerge from this crisis. But the impact has been profound. During the 2008-09 financial crisis in quarter one, 2009, we lost £309 million. In quarter two this year, we reported a loss of £711 million. That was at the very start of the crisis. It's now October, and we know this is not a short-term issue. The huge reduction in travel, and especially business travel, has forced us to restructure our business, seen jobs lost, we've sold assets, and we said goodbye to our 747 fleet. And we have been working continually to alter our flight schedules to deal with the changes in travel restrictions and quarantine measures. But this is an industry issue that requires a whole industry response. We all need to work together right now to revive our industry. So how safe is flying? We think the risk to public health of flying is low. IATA, the global aviation industry body, suggests that since the start of 2020, there have been as few as 44 cases of COVID-19 linked to flights. 44 cases. Over the same period, some 1.2 billion people travelled. This figure amounts to one case for every 27 million travellers. I don't know about you, but I find these figures pretty reassuring. More so when you understand that the vast majority of published cases occurred before the wearing of face coverings in flight became widespread. To be clear, the safety of our customers and crew is always our number one priority, and we are taking every safety measure to keep our customers safe. This is a multifaceted approach and includes minimising contact, sanitising our aircraft from nose to tail, and asking customers and crew to wear face masks at all times unless they have a medical exemption. In the cabin, air is completely replaced every 2 to 3 minutes, passing through HEPA filters which remove microscopic bacteria and virus clusters with over a 99.9% efficiency, like being in a hospital theatre. We know public safety is key for the government, so it should be reassured by IATA's new figures. We need ministers to work with us to make the right decisions for citizens and our industry. Our position at British Airways is that we do not believe quarantine is the solution. We believe the best way to reassure people is to introduce a reliable and affordable test before flying. For the UK, this approach reduces the stress on the NHS testing systems within the UK and on policing the quarantine system. If we look abroad to our near neighbours, we see that business travel and indeed tourism is being prioritised by some countries. We need to get our economy moving again, and this just isn't possible when you're asking people to quarantine for 14 days. It's our view that even if that quarantine period is reduced to, say, 7 days, people won't travel here and the UK will get left behind. So what needs to happen? We say we need a fundamental rethink. Pre-flight testing lets our customers know the risk of travelling in close proximity to someone who is infected is low, and governments can be confident they are not importing the disease. The decision on which is the most appropriate test is for the authorities to decide, although the antigen test is developing quickly. It is fast, reliable and affordable. But whichever test a country requires, PCR tests included, we think pre-departure testing is the way forward. Introducing a rapid pre-departure testing regime could not be more important. I'm going to use the example of the US to help me explain this. The total loss in trade between the US and the UK is predicted to be £45.8 billion due to closed borders. I cannot stress more greatly that air connectivity between the UK and USA is fundamental for supporting economic growth and trade on both sides of the Atlantic. Pre-COVID, British Airways flew to almost 30 destinations in the US. Now it's less than half that. We normally fly to New York up to 12 times a day. It's now twice per day with fewer than 200 passengers most days. In the first instance, we need to work together on a testing pilot so flights can start between London and New York, traditionally one of the busiest airline routes in the world. To do this, first we need an agreement between the US and UK governments to reopen without blanket quarantine measures. At the moment, we are not getting any support or action, and we're not hearing from governments what they're thinking. Airlines and industry bodies like IATA are offering their expertise to develop health passports, but we do not see government doing any of this. Secondly, we need cost-effective testing before flying, with a quick, safe and accurate test for every passenger on affected routes. I realise that the title of this keynote address is beyond the crisis, but I need to be clear that there is a risk that as an industry, we will not see beyond this crisis if we do not first address the issue of how we get people flying again. Everything else is for another day. Thank you.